Welcome back. So we're going to continue mystery solving. Last we left off, we made some progress in this lab. In fact, you see a screenshot of the lab right in front of you. We had assembled a small Tesla coil, solved a number of mysteries just to be able to get access to the lab, most prominently solving the keycard reader. And in case you've forgotten, because I have already, here's what Nico tells us.
The hours have gone negative this week. The news of the announcement has gone far beyond what I wanted. I've lost control over it, and we're not ready. Marie's been helping me comb through all the unsuitable work. I've had to step up my own security. I can't be too careful now. The mood in the lab has been tense for a long time, but there has been a shift.
So if that doesn't build suspense, I don't know what does. No, that's definitely paranoia.
I find myself unable to trust anyone here, but it can't leave the work. Not until it's announced. There's electricity in everything, but we don't know how to see it because we perceive it to be scarce. Always looking for exotic solutions. Exotic and costly. Victor once warned me to take it easy with the announcement. The world economy is built on expensive energy. To flood the market could cause a collapse, but to continue to hide the resources we have, to deprive those who need them, see why Tesla liked his pigeons. They fly only where they're directed, and never question the effect the beating of their wings will have on the skies and the world below.
Okay. Well, these messages just keep getting more and more cryptic. Man, that's one cool painting. And there's Nikola Tesla. I wonder, are there other pictures of him? Because, like, we see that picture both in the lobby, as well as here. And, like, you see that picture. In fact, let me show off the other place you see that picture. Well, let's go back to the lobby. So, there was a picture of Tesla, in fact, right over here. It's the same picture, just with a different coloring. And you go back over here, you got a book. Oh, hey, look! It's actually a different picture. So, I'm mistaken. This game does have more than one picture of Nikola Tesla. I was going to say, you can't keep putting his face everywhere unless you have different pictures of him, but they do. Alright. So, remaining tasks. See what's inside Nico's notebook.
Still have to do that.
Manufacture the missing part through a Tesla coil. I failed that twice. I'm going to try it again. Repairing the Tesla coil. Probably requires manufacturing the missing part, and figure out where what the extra data on that video means. So one of these at a time. In order to be able to manufacture the part, I have to go submit the print job. To submit the print job, I have to approach a mason's office at night. Because during the day, he's not going to let me use his computer. It's his own computer. I mean, it does belong to the lab, but he doesn't want me on his computer. I don't blame him. So rather than cause a fight, we're going to wait 12 hours and then go up secretly behind his back using his computer. Which is the far more diplomatic solution. Not really. So this is the design I've been struggling with. We're gonna try it yet again and probably fail it again, but you know, if at first you don't succeed, keep failing, eventually you might get it. Alright, so that's layer one as far as I can see. If I rotate this right, we need two more blocks here. If I rotate this again, I can't see any need for additional blocks from that perspective. And from this perspective, I'm not sure if I need a block. Not there, right? That would stand out. No. Maybe back here. I can't tell. It's difficult to ascertain from that final picture. No, but from this topmost picture, clearly there's not a block there. Are there blocks anywhere else? Like, these five squares are vacant. How about the one gap on the right and the gap on the left? Are those gaps indeed? Like, there's a gap there. There's a gap there. Yeah, no, I think this is correct for layer one. All right, layer two. It's going to be a block here and a block there. All right, go around. I can't really see squat from this layer, but there's going to be one on top of that. And then it extends all the way across that channel. Okay, diagram four suggests there's a block in the center on layer two. Right? Is that a block or is that a gap? It's extremely difficult to tell. I'm going to go with that's a gap. What do you say, Twitch? Is that a block there or is that a gap? I'm going to get up really close to the screen. That's a block. I think that's what I missed last time, is that there is a block right here. Okay, swivel it once more. Wait. What perspective am I looking at again? Yeah, so. Doo-doo-doo-doo. I like this song. It's a really nice track. Oh, now there's clearly a gap in here. All right, spin it again. That looks... Ooh, that doesn't look good at all. Is there a block here? Yeah. Okay, and this last diagram looks okay. I'm still debating should this be here or not. I think it should. Okay, back to number one. One checks out. Two checks out. It's hard to tell. Three seems to check out. Four checks out. Okay. Number one again. Where do these blocks go? Like there? And then this vertical pipe back here. This vertical. I think that's it for perspective one. Perspective two, we have a block spanning this gap. No. Block spanning what gap? Oh, here we are. Yeah, there we are. So, am I missing anything here? No, that looks fine. Layer. Okay, here. I'm not seeing that I'm missing anything. And here, that looks fine. Layer four, it's gonna be not there, but here. We're crossing that channel. That looks okay. That looks okay. That looks fine. Is there anything more in layer four? That seems to match up. That looks all well and good. I'm still conflicted about this layer two. Like, should this be here? It's really tricky to tell from the diagram. Like, if I remove that, I can't see the difference over here. This is a sad schematic done from an ever so slightly different angle. That's really frustrating. This is a good game in principle, at least this mini game. But the perspective is just ever so slightly different. And that's modestly infuriating. Well, with 100% of the votes in, that is nobody voting. I think we're saying this is good to go. I could take a screenshot of this, but it wouldn't serve me any good because I can't see the screenshot from the game. Well, at least let me know where I've been. There's my screenshot. Can always revisit that if I'm absolutely forced to, but... Oh, I could actually take a picture of what I'm doing, too. I forgot I have a camera right here. So I could just... Oh. How much of this can I capture? Yeah. So let's take the photo. Sure, we'll save it. I really don't expect to need to access that. Because, I don't know. I'm most likely to be successful if I do this from scratch anyhow. Like, I don't see the value in trying to recall earlier solutions, so...
I think that's right!
Thank God. Okay. It's about damn time, Nancy. If you could have said that before I submitted all those things to the queue, that would have been helpful, you know? But okay, we'll take what we can get. Alright, step out of the elevator, get back into the lounge. To submit that to the printer, we'll wait for daytime. Once daytime strikes, then we don't have to deal with the head of security, who's only there at night for some reason. I mean, he can't be there all 24 hours, but do we really think that there's a greater security threat at night than during the day? I'm not sure. 3D printer. Print me a thing. Alright, that'll take half a day to process. Let's see. Do we want to say hi to Ryan again? I think we do, just to, I don't know, lighten the nerves a bit. So, let's talk with Ryan.
Hi!
Hi!
I'll let you go. Bye.
Bye! Okay, well, that was quick. That was fun. So, does Mason have anything to tell us? Like, why have I been printing so many things that I'm not aware of?
Bye.
Goodbye.
I suppose not. Alright. Well, that said, let's wait for the device to print. The game makes an allusion to Nico's notebook. I don't think we've seen that. Alright, we wait another night and another day. Emerges. So I should say we wait another day and another night passes. To be more clear about what's going on. All right. And it's possible, maybe, like I said this last stream, maybe you can go into the lab while the head of security's here. I don't think he'd be happy to find us here. At all. Like, we don't have permission to access the lab, period. And so, he'd be completely within his rights to say, you know, you need to leave the building. So, not messing with that. Cool. So, we printed that. Now we have to go insert said part into the coil somehow. All right.
That's done. Have it done that.
All right. So,
still have to do that.
Still have to repair the coil. What remains to be repaired? So we've inserted the missing part. We've, I don't know what else there is to fix about it. What else is there to fix? So we've looked at the computer, we've printed on the 3D printer, we've etched a wafer. There's still nothing to do there. Oh yeah, this. Okay, maybe it's the Undertale theme. Yeah, that doesn't seem right. Somehow I don't think I got that right. Faraday cage is starting to fail. If sent a materials request to Victor, may need to refabricate the cage before winter. Ellie should be made aware of the issue, of course. As long as it's only the two of us using the coil, it should hold for a while longer. Reminder, call Victor to have him expedite the materials before something disastrous happens. Need photosensitive paint, Faraday materials, magnets, and USB drives. Scientist at Tribune, fabricating stories about my work, add to media blacklist. More research materials are missing today. Keep closer watch on Ellie.
Have it done that.
Oh, actually, yeah, this would be Nico's notebook. This is definitely Nico's handwriting. Because it doesn't correspond to anybody else's handwriting, so it's got to be Nico's. I think you're mistaken. I have not beaten this game before. I'm a bit confused by this particular cryptogram. Or whatever it is. So, I think this is these are way too many notes for a single song on that Tesla machine. So what's the point? DFBAA. Well, I mean, we could try this. Let's see, what was next? A, A, A. Well, there's no low A. And then what was it that was next? B, G, E, G. Yeah, these are way too many notes. F, B, B, C. I mean, I think I entered that accurately according to what was shown upstairs. F being on the higher octave. Yeah, that's the note I had there. An octave skip, and then the C would be this C. Oops, wrong book. This book. B, D, E, F, C. Okay. B, D, E, F, C, E, B, A. And what was next? D, A, G, C. I don't see the point of this song, if indeed this is the song. This can't possibly be what I'm expected to do. The lower notes correspond to... the lowercase letters correspond to a higher octave, as we saw from Mason's whiteboard. But that really doesn't tell us what to do about this grid of 14 by 6 characters. Unless this is saying go like 9 characters and 14 and 10 and 4, but there aren't enough for us to make a song that way. What if we just do 9 out, 10 out, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, this can't possibly be right. I don't know how to read this. Let's go back to Mason's board. To do that, we'll need to approach at night. So let's approach... yeah. But if you did see me beat this once, I would be interested in knowing how I managed to beat it. Okay, so Mason's office has got this whiteboard. It's got this keyboard up in here, but I don't see anything indicating how to read this grid of letters. Okay, I know I have solved a number of puzzles in this game, but I've never successfully beaten it. At least this is way, way more accessible than Myst. Myst is just a pain. So, do 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 do. So, I don't know, I might end up taking more hints just for the sake of keeping the game going. I really like the way he organizes his office. It's a work of art. Is there anything worth noting here? Capacitor adjustments, frequency modifications, coil gauge alterations, correction of field test. Toroid configuration results, frequency modifications, energy resources, terrestrial stationary waves. That's funny. That's like a standing wave that's Earth-based. Like, I don't know, forever ago, Tesla invented this kind of earthquake machine, and this seems to be what this is referring to. Is a wave that's part of the Earth. Alright, reconfigured frequency, redesigned for coil measurements, or call measurements, but I think that's supposed to say coil. Or maybe call, C-O-L, collection? I don't know. Q factor findings, toward in patent draft, Earth resonance adaptation prototype. Again, this harkens back to something that Tesla said he was doing with an earthquake machine. So, we've got to be careful and watch our step. Let's play some component craze. Ready? I'm not doing so well now, am I? Really not doing so well. Ay, ay, ay. Nope, the resistor is over here. Capacitor. That was lucky. Not so lucky. Where's my battery? That's not a battery. That's a diode. There's an IC. Diode. That's not my diode. That's not my diode. Inductor. Well, you can tell where my attention span is at. It says that this is supercharged. I do not feel supercharged. We're going to try that again. This is really what matters. Switch resistor, speaker, transistor, capacitor, battery, diode. Never lucky. Never lucky. Oh, that's not right. Battery, inductor, inductor, fuse, diode, transistor, speaker. Is that speaker? Resistor. All these things look the same. Battery, nope, fuse, diode, IC, is this an IC? Yes, this is switch, I don't remember where anything is. Wow, this is pretty pathetic. Still beat a minute. Still not happy with that. Let's try it again. Nope. Why do I suck so bad at this game? Okay, that's my record is still 38. That could have gone a lot better, but you know, I beat it, so there should be a Steam achievement for that. Probably is, and I probably earned it months ago and have forgotten about it. That's okay.
What were you doing with Nico's things? How did you find those? So you were hiding them? Stay out of my things, hun. You don't know what you're messing with. You never said why you hid some of Nico's work. I'm not supposed to have them, but I see you get that.
Okay.
If you have to ask why I go out of my way to understand how someone like Nico thought, then you obviously don't realize what a big deal he is.
That's true.
And he wanted to keep them from Mason.
Okay.
He hated Mason.
Did he say why?
Honey, would you ask anyone to explain why they hate Mason?
Fair enough, fair enough.
Did you think Nico's work was important?
Not was. Is.
Important enough to kill for?
Yes, more than was.
Whoa, what do you mean by that?
Look around. Life isn't just life anymore. It's plugged in all the time. People live in this weird dream world of their own creation. We are running out of power, and fast. Imagine the jolt when we all wake up together. Nico cracked it. A way to harvest the electricity that's already there all around us. Or, so I heard. I never saw his work.
Okay.
His work is so important, it can't be measured in money. It's pure power. Economic, political, military, and literal power beyond measure.
Jeez.
Wars have been fought for far less.
Good to know.
Bye.
Goodbye, Nancy.
Yeah, I like how, gosh darn it, how have I forgotten her name already? Ellie. Ellie's desk is so organic and not organized. And Mason's desk is the complete opposite. I don't think either one of them is to be hated. Yeah, I forgot something.
Bye.
I just want to invade your space and look at all the things, but nah. Apparently I cannot do that. Can't bother Ryan while Ryan's asleep and not here. So back to the lounge we go. All right, here we go. I suppose I could have bothered Gray again.
Can't check that off yet.
Anybody have suggestions as to what to do? Wait, so I've already printed the part. We're in the lab. You know, we could stand in the middle and freely rotate about and look at everything. But I'm missing, like, what's inside Nico's notebook. I mean, I'm certainly reading this, I just don't understand it at all. So, if we don't have suggestions, I'm going to resort to hints, because this kind of cryptogram looks really tricky to solve. 9, 6, 2, 7, 14, 3, 1, 8, 10, 12, 11, 13, 4, 13, 12, 7. I mean, what if I go 9, and then 14, 1, 2, 7, 9, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... 14 puts me there, and then 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 4, and then 6, and then 3, and then 12, 1, 5, 9, 13, 12, and then 13, 1, and then 5, 9, wait, 1, 5, 9, 13, and then I go 2. Well, I don't even know if I should count the ones I already crossed or not. Let's not count already crossed letters. 1. Ooh, that looks weird. Let's cross that and then go 1. And then 11, 4, 8, 10, 11, and then go 12, and then go 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then go 8, 1, okay, 8 puts us here, and then 13, 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 12, 13, and then 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, that doesn't tell me much. Yeah, I did find all the pieces to the cat. The cat doesn't seem to tell me anything. It's just a cat.
Have it done that.
So that's apparently not it. What if these only indicate letters within the zone box? Like if I go 9 and then 6 and then 2 and then 7. And then here I go 14, 3, 4, or 1, and then 8. This doesn't seem to be spelling anything of use. What if I scratch out everything but those letters? There's 9. Yeah, no, I'd end up scratching everything out if I did it that way. Hint. Yeah, no, that's really not helpful. Seriously not helpful. Only because if I mouse over this, I see I could scratch the things out. I can't tell how much to skip. So we're going to resort to hint number 2. Binary. Okay, that's helpful. 9, 6, 2, 7, 14, 3, 1, 8, 10, 12, 11, 13, that's not right, there's 13. 4, 13, that's not right, there we go, 12, 7.
By every fifth letter above, I'm a coil. Okay, I'll give that a try.
Okay, cool. See, that was easy. Just had to figure out that there was a binary aspect to that. Every fifth letter above on the coil. Okay, we can give that a try. Some of you might be flummoxed as to how I managed to do such binary feats. Yeah. I've done a bit with computers. A bit too much. Oops, that's not it. Notebook. A, G, be. AGBEG. GC. Okay. AA. G B lowercase a d a d a what else? A C A. That's not the C. Yeah, the game did have other binary puzzles. It's just, it's been months since I last played this. Okay, apparently that's not accurate. A, G, B. Every fifth letter A above play on the coil. Well, I think I've read this correctly, right? Let me type this out. So it's A, 1, 2, G, B, E, G, A, G, D, B, C, G, E, F, D, C. Okay, we're gonna try that. A, G, B, E, G, A, G, D, B, C, G, E, F, D, C. That's far more melodious. Nice. Found a thing. The closer I come to the answer, the more I appreciate the magnitude of this discovery. I fear that I can no longer trust those around me. I cannot allow my research to go wasted, unknown. So, to find the hidden challenge, illuminate a black light under the glow. Okay.
Did that.
Cool. Maybe I should go bug Ryan. It's been a while since we said hi to Ryan. Plus, we seem to be suspecting everybody except Ryan now, so it wouldn't hurt for us to go back and become a little bit more suspicious. Oh, fourth wall breaks.
What's up? I think there may be something weird about the security video from the night of the murder. Could you take a look at it with me?
Yes.
Nice.
This track is something Nico had me add, so the security video could also do double duty as a data set.
Oh.
He liked tracking the ebb and flow of the electrical current throughout the year. It meant something to him. I've heard that theoretically we could... Wait.
What?
Right there. And there. Let me get a closer look. It's true. There are breaks in the signature.
Ooh, that's not good.
Just happened.
That footage must have been flagged. Whoever killed Nico knows what we just saw.
Where are you going?
Anywhere but here. If you're smart, you do the same.
Ah, shit. That's not good. Well, I don't think... Well, okay. Well, we learned something.
Did that. Still have to do that. Still have to do that.
Track down the source of the alarm. Well, that's not good.
Haven't done that.
Well, we gotta track down the source of the alarm. It says it was in the Tesla coil lab, but... Can I chicken out and not go into the lab for a second? Because I'd much rather not visit the lab if I don't have to. Well, that escalated quickly. Whoops. Oh. Everybody seems to be out. That's not cool. So, am I literally the only person remaining here? That's no good. Makes sense that Ryan took off. Let's see, can we go into Gray's room? Oh, Gray's office is locked. Well, the game dictates that we must go this way, so let's do it.
What are you doing here?
I was going to ask you the same thing.
This might come as a shock, but no one wants you lurking around here. Why didn't you just leave me to my work?
I'm not lurking. What's that?
Wait, stop. Someone's activated the machine. You have to shut it all down. Please, hurry.
Crap. Okay. How do we do this?
I need to find a way to turn off all of the power.
Okay. Hopefully I don't suck at this too badly. Oops, that didn't work. Shit. Anybody got bright ideas? 'Cause otherwise we're all gonna die. Shoot! Why couldn't they have made this an easier puzzle? We're all gonna die. It's been nice knowing y'all. Oh dear. Yep. Well, we tried. We endeavored. Hopefully there's not a time limit on this. 'Cause if there is, Mason's done for, as are we all. Seriously, who does security for this lab? Just asking.
There, got it.
Okay.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Who could have turned that on?
No clue. Look, maybe we can keep this between ourselves, okay?
What are you doing? Nancy, we should have a talk. Come on. Nice job. You saved me some paperwork back there.
Phew. Wait, what?
Looks like your ride is going to be a little late. Get settled in the lounge and please, don't touch anything. I'm going to need all of your passes and keys. Where did you even get this? No, I don't even want to know.
What's going to happen next?
Snow clears, you leave. I leave, hire a professional next time. Killer gets found, killer goes to jail.
Okay, we saved Mason, right?
Your next step with the investigation.
I'm sorry if I've been anything but crystal clear. I want you off this case. Completely.
Hey.
You've caused enough trouble here.
Okay.
I'll let you go.
Mm-hmm.
Well.
Did that.
You know, it's probably a good idea that I actually do what he suggests, you know?
Can't check that off yet.
Busy right now.
Goodbye.
Yeah.
Fine. Okay. Sure. Whatever. Might as well say hi and bye to everybody. It's funny that Victor didn't frisk me and, like, ask for all of my stuff. You know, considering that I could have all of his research. Hey.
So, what exactly happened with you and the coil?
I, miscalculated.
Why were you in there?
You saved my life. I thank you. That's it. Conversation over.
Fine. Okay, I'm totally cool with that.
Any word on the storm?
It's gonna be bad. I'd get out of here before we get snowed in. I know I'm going to.
Bye.
See you later.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Huh. Usually he's a lot more ticked off when I try to go into Ellie's space. He seemed a lot calmer that time.
Did you hear? A snowstorm of gloriously epic proportions is bearing down on us. I might get to break out the snowmobile.
Ha!
Or we might get snowed in like last time.
Well, damn.
I need a new key card. Can you help?
Well, sorta. Here, this should do the trick.
Oh, seriously? Yes. Your key card? You're giving me that?
What happens if a big storm hits?
Then we're stuck.
Is there any way into town?
You could use the snowmobiles, but those are for emergencies only. Or things I can write off as emergencies in order to ride them.
Hey, now we're talking.
I need your help distracting Victor.
I've got just the thing.
What is it?
Listen.
Shit.
That is awful.
I know. Victor hates it. Like mega super hates it to infinity. If I leave this thing running for more than a second, he'll be yelling at me to turn it off.
Perfect.
But Nancy, I also hate it. And I hate getting yelled at by Victor. So whatever you need to do, please do it quickly. Okay, I'll give you a minute and then I'll let her rip.
Okay. Sure. I guess that's what I called for. See. Yeah, security office is locked. Fine.
It's locked.
All right. Oh, we found a way back into the lab. Illuminate a black light under the glow. I'm not seeing... Like, I don't have a black light or something with which to illuminate stuff. Yep. Frankly, I'm not sure what I'm doing here. Alright, we don't need to be in there. I can head out of there. Is there anything of note in this space at all? Again, just for the sake of keeping things moving, like I could randomly explore and click on everything for quite a while. But it might be more productive for me to do something else. Note. Yep, we got the note. Got Nico's diary. We got the notebook. The book of solutions. Oh, search Victor's office. There's a thought. This isn't exactly Victor's office, but I think this is what you were alluding to. I've already examined that desk drawer countless times. But the code to here, I mean, it's not going to change anything. 171943. He's gonna be pissed if he finds me with that. But yeah, I can use this to open the cabinet. Look at all these devices. Is there nothing worth taking in this cabinet? By the way, I've seen part of a playthrough once. I think these messages... Yeah. These messages let you know that you really ought to be moving. None of those are black lights. So I've got a key. It's one more key than I used to have. Wait. Is there a coat or a jacket over there? I thought I saw something. I'd like to investigate that coat, except maybe it's my coat. Oh well. Tasks. So I don't know why I took that key. I mean, I could say hi to Victor, right? Oh, fine.
Bye.
Mm-hmm. Could always push the big red button on the first floor. I mean, who doesn't want to push the button? So pushable.
Hi. I'd better get going.
Okay. So, yeah, let's go say hi to Ellie. It's been a while. She only appears here at night. I don't understand why I have that key, though. I'm really confused. Oops. Okay, let's go wait for nighttime. Dude, I've pushed that button so many dozens of times. And yes, I'm gonna tease you until I have another reason to push it. Like, basically my entire last stream consisted of me of repeatedly hitting that button. And trying to create a key card. But the button pushing was the more prominent aspect of that.
This is a lab, not your personal playground. Get back to the visitor's area.
Do you not sleep?
Bye.
Mm-hmm.
Just asking. Okay. Noted. I mean, 12 hours ago he was just there at that desk. He's still there. Oh, how many days do you think he's going to sit at that desk? Oh wait, what's this? Come on. I want the thing. Can I have the thing, please? No, fine. We'll go into the office. What's up, Bailey?
Hope you brought a good book and some candles. Sounds like we are getting snowed in.
Bummer.
Do you know what Mason was doing with a coil?
Getting his comeuppance. I heard about what happened. For a genius, he really is dumb sometimes.
Whatever. That's...
Bye.
Bye.
That's really polite.
Forget something? I'll let you go. Bye.
Okay. Nothing worth seeing there. Nothing worth seeing here as far as I can see. I could click on everything, but aside from this little ring on the table, there's nothing of interest. Pretty sure Ryan's not there. It's interesting that, usually this door is barricaded a different way, I thought. Whatever. Plus, you would think that, having not repaired the coil, that Mason would not be in any danger there, but... Again, that's just my imagination being active. Well, that's cool.
What do you want?
Did you know Victor is here?
Yes.
You don't seem happy about that.
I'm not. No follow-ups.
Fine.
I get the sense Nico is protecting you. Why?
Couldn't read his mind then. Still can't now.
Huh. Strange.
Bye.
Yeah, I guess if anybody were to have a black... Are you looking at me?
What else now?
Bye.
Yeah.
You don't need to be looking at me. Fine. All about face. And since you guys inquired so kindly about the button, we're gonna hit the button. Only because you guys inquired so kindly about it. Also because there might be a black light here somewhere. Though I'm not seeing one. You would think that if anybody had a black light anyway. It's not one there. Yeah, let's just get out of here. So anybody got ideas? Could always play another game of aggregation. It's been forever. Mason has beaten our high score. So the score to beat is 24,775. Yeah. Oops. Well, that's no good. Let's quit. Or maybe do it this way. Oops. I am so bad at this. Okay, we're quitting. You didn't see that. Starting again. Starting anew. And this time trying to plan more than one move ahead. That may prove challenging. Okay. There we go. Easy peasy. You'd ask Ryan, the engineer. Okay. Couldn't hurt. Okay. Arg. All right. Dissolving the last few blocks is a little bit challenging. Okay, can we get a blue? Yes. All right. And now the puzzles begin in earnest. Wow, there's a lot of colors and shapes here to consider. It's not exactly what I was going for. We've got more greens than we know what to do with. Okay, wow, this is not going perfectly. Okay, a yellow one might be useful from this angle. Right. Okay, purple could be useful from that angle. Green from the bottom could be useful. Orange from the top could be very useful. Oh, that's not what I was looking for. Seriously? How many of these are you going to give me? Okay. It's the big plan. I think I've solved this game, by the way. Or at least come up with a really good strategy. Alright, oh, but yeah, I forgot about these gates. These gates make this more challenging. Wow. Okay. Let's get a blue. Yeah, I have to go this way, don't I? Alright. Let's join that together. Join our dark blues. There we go. Oh, seriously? There we go. Nice. So close to the high score, guys. So close. Oops. I slightly miscalculated there. In an enormous way. Just funny. Okay, all we want's the high score. Wait, does that? Oh no, they're not joined. My mistake. Okay. Aggregation is a nice name for such an aggravating game. Okay, so yeah, that's kind of a mess. Okay, let's send the purple block in this way and clear it out like that. I got two blue blocks coming. Oh, three blue blocks. Nice. We don't have any yellow blocks, so let's use this to clear the yellows. Okay. Send a purple from the left. And there's our green. And we're so close, and yet so far. Let's send a blue up that way. Another blue? Nice. High score? Yeah! Alright, we're gonna ask Ryan for help. Eat that, Mason. Okay. Well, that was a useful diversion. There's still nothing worth grabbing here in the lounge. It's hard to believe that Mason's that addicted to aggravation, or aggregation, rather. Yeah, possibly Ryan could help us out. Right, there's nothing over here. Can I touch any of this? I know I've asked Ryan questions about this before, but doesn't seem anything's touchable about it.
Hi.
So all I can ask Ryan for is for her to distract Victor. Yeah, she totally has a black light somewhere.
I'll let you go. Bye.
All right. Let's just call these other people with Ryan right there.
Hey there,
I found proof that the video was doctored.
That's almost interesting. Did you find the full
Are you serious?
Not yet.
Well, top, girl detective. I got me a deadline.
Well, thanks for your help.
Victor's here.
And Ned's here.
What?
Just kidding.
Nice try.
What exactly did you say to Victor when he called for a reference? not going to be angry. I really need to know. Verbatim.
Verbatim? I was surprised the guy hired you. Your other representative must have canceled me out.
Maybe. Do me a favor. No more references.
Do me a favor. Stop having everyone always ask me about you. I get that you're so amazing or whatever, but I don't need to be reminded every 5 seconds.
Well, fine. Okay.
Bye.
Hang it up.
All right. Hi. How's it going? I'm gonna call you again. Just kidding. Oh, I should totally call Victor next.
Hi.
Victor's here.
Why? Yeah, why?
I guess I failed. I'm off the case.
Really? Nancy Drew leaving an unsolved case? Unlikely.
I was so close. Things got more complicated when he showed up. And there's something else.
What?
I'm a little snowed in.
Snowed in with a killer? This is not good.
Tell me about it.
Play it cool. Since we're way out here, you might have to rely on someone on site. Choose wisely.
You didn't tell me twice. The security video was doctored. But when I found that out, someone on the network was notified.
Who else would set that up, but...
Can you two look into that for me?
You got it. I'll call you the second I know.
I'll let you go.
All right.
Later.
Have fun with that, guys. Gotta call Victor.
You've reached Victor Lawson. Please leave a message at the tone.
Oh, fine. I was wondering what would happen if you did that. Apparently not much. Okay. We're going to ask the game for a hint, just so things keep moving. Try looking around the tech workshop. I mean, that makes sense. Aww. Aren't you cute? Around the tech workshop. There's nothing there.
A blacklight.
Oh.
This might be what Nico was talking about.
Okay, sure. Nice. Yeah, that makes sense.
I'm sorry to ask again, but can you distract me?
Dear ears and general feelings of self, I am so sorry for what's about to happen to you. Your sad friend,
Ryan. Okay, cool. You know, I might have wanted to check if I had a power source before engaging in this. Oh well. Oh well. Illuminating a black light under the glow. There somewhere, I mean, Nico was in the lab quite a bit. No. Where could I possibly use the black light in the lab to achieve something of purpose? Nope. Is there anywhere I could use this black light? And how do I illuminate it? Oh, does the glow mean... Probably gonna die from this. Well, I'm in trouble, and I haven't any clue where I should be going. This is frustrating. Oh. Wait, we've got an illuminated black light. Just under the glow, I don't know. What the shit does under the glow mean?
This is a lab, not your personal playground. Get back to the visitors' area.
Bye. I'd better get going.
Bye.
In the name of science. Clearly, that's what 60-something-year-old Nico had intended. As that kind of experiment be done in the name of science. I can't imagine what else Nico possibly could have meant when he said illuminate a black light under the glow.
Hi. I'd better get going.
Could find a cure. It's true. It's not the only thing we could find. Well, should I resort to more hints, since we actually have an audience? And since I'm still stumped as heck as to what to do with this black light? Somehow I've managed to charge a black light that's not plugged in. Which makes no sense, but video game logic. Or shall I just randomly keep clicking everything randomly until we find something? I could do that too. I did see a walkthrough or playthrough forever ago. It did show me what to do here, and I just don't remember. We're gonna take a hint. Just to keep the show moving. Okay, it's safe to walk around or walk into the room when it's on low. Oh, wait.
Can't check that off yet.
Okay. So, that's all that means. Okay. Fine. I'm kind of opposed to doing this at night, but sure, why not? Glow. That's what we shall call this. We're gonna hit the button. Maybe the fact that I've only done this during the day is the determining factor. I really don't like this idea of being in the lab at night. I'm not seeing any light switch or anything of that sort here.
This has to lead to whatever Nico was hiding. A biometric fingerprint scanner. This could be a challenge.
Damn. Well, at least you figured out what illuminating the black light under the glow means. Now let's get the crap out of here before we're discovered. Okay, well, that was an adventure and a half. Definitely
Jack.
Illuminated the black light under the glow. I guess the key was doing that at night. Find a way past the biometric finger scanner. Alrighty. Ryan's pretty handy. Maybe she'll have some idea how we can get past that. Like, in terms of information, other characters have been useful, but in terms of having an assistant, Ryan has been the bomb.
Just in case you were wondering, yes, Victor's yelling is starting to crush my soul a little bit.
Sorry.
I made a chart to illustrate my feelings on the situation.
Oh, can I please see this? Wow.
It turns out, it's very boring. That is also why there is a dragon and a dog on the skateboard and other stuff.
Okay, cool.
Is there anything I can do to convince you to give me some of your gummy bears?
Yes. Victor is a candy hoarder. Liberate his sugar stash and bring it to me.
His sugar stash... Sugar stash. Do I have any candies?
You seem pretty attached to gummy bears.
Attached? Please. I less than three them.
Less than three.
And sugary, and sometimes a girl gets a little lonely surrounded by all these scientists. Plus they're fun. And you can act out these little scenes with them and then eat them.
Wow. It's no wonder they don't entrust you with the lab security. Just saying.
I'd better get going.
Bye.
All right. Do I have any candies? I have no candies. That's too bad. Sugar stash. Well, we are going to attempt to liberate the sugar stash. I assume by that you just mean win the memory game here. There's nothing here called a sugar stash. So you guys are going to have to help me figure out which one to take. But...
Don't touch that.
Are you serious? You suck. Fine. Don't touch that. He's been at his desk for the last 24 to 48 hours, just sitting there. The entire time. I mean, he has no sense. Well, okay.
Ryan promised to give me some if I helped her. I should wait.
I don't even...
Haven't done that.
Okay, where did Ryan go? Ryan's AFK. Okay, I just imagined that I saw Ryan here. So in terms of getting into Victor's office, it looks like I've got to push the button. I can't just rely on Ryan.
Hey.
I beat your high score again. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Yeah. Actually, aggregation is a good game in concept. Can you imagine a some sort of Tetris-like game like aggregation? Where there are chess pieces, and the chess pieces have to move around the blocks, and it can be really confusing. Alright, well, we're going to hit the big red button in order to get Victor out of his office.
Not a good time.
Can I have some of your candy?
Oh, okay.
I better get going.
Yeah.
So, Victor doesn't care about that button. I thought I'd have to play the memory game a million times to... Okay, whatever. Nice. Find a way past the biometric fingerprint scanner. Well, so we're gonna need a fingerprint. Where would I even find that? Can Ryan give me advice?
Bye.
Bye.
All I want is advice. Where do I get a fingerprint? Well, I guess it could be anybody's fingerprint, right? Could I take this remote, maybe? I don't know. Like, what would have fingerprints on it? Do I have anything in my evidence? I'm not sure that any of that would suffice. Got electronics, the user's guide. We got Edward Shellington, Esquire the Second, a shredded page. An unknown card. That would help. Ryan's card might help. There's one on the scanner from its last user. by on the scanner. Scanner. Oh, okay. Yeah, that makes sense. So, oh crap. That's not good. So what do we do?
I need to replace all of these gears before the brakes give out.
Okay. Let's do that then. Wait, does that not fit? I need a larger gear. That doesn't fit. That doesn't fit. That's no good. Oh, looks like we're dead, guys. It's been a fun game. Hope you've enjoyed. No, we're gonna try. We're gonna try our damnedest to get out of this, but it's not looking good. Can this fit here? I don't know if all these gears are in 3 sizes or 4 or 7 or how many sizes of gears there are. Ouch! Woo! Never push the button that causes the elevator to plummet to the earth like a ton of bricks. Oh, okay. Yeah, that would be the wrong button. Bummer. All right, let's try again. It's a good elevator tip for those of you unfamiliar with the operation of elevators. All right. Well, that only took 2 attempts. Thank goodness.
That's done.
Okay. That was enough eventfulness for this instant. I really don't feel like exploring the lab at night unless I'm absolutely compelled to. So we'll explore it during the day and assume that Victor will leave us be if I just hit the magic button, even though I don't think that matters. Okay. Let's go into here. Oh, picture. Picture, picture, picture. I'm not sure that that helps me much. And my question actually isn't so much who used the scanner, but how to bypass the scanner. Um, I've actually seen this particular part of the game before. So, I actually remember you have to, like, produce a mold that can capture a fingerprint or something of that sort. But I don't remember how it is that you produce the mold. Ah, Mason beat our score, guys. Bummer. Yeah, no, I think the game was joking with you about the don't push the button that causes the elevator to plummet. Pretty sure the game was joking that there's not actually a plummet button. But maybe. You might have an elevator that...
I'd better get going.
Bye.
All right, a receptacle. A receptacle... not seeing a receptacle of some sort that in which I can melt gummy bears. Cat's not gonna help me. Aww, aren't you cute? Okay, fine. Thing in which to melt gummy bears. Might there be such a container in the lab? You would think that finding a container would be trivial. But Nancy seems unwilling or unable to examine this room and look for something that can contain gummy bears. Oh, look, I found a tape. Okay, sure.
I need to find something to melt these in.
Oh, wait a second. I can use a tape to collect a fingerprint. Not helping. Do I have to have somebody tell me how fingerprints work? I think that might come to that. Coffee mug or an actual beaker? Okay, where do I find a coffee mug or a beaker or something? I guess I just go looking around the lab, because there's nothing like that up here. Like, Mason might have something like that in his office, but he's not going to let me examine that while he's here. So I have to go looking around somewhere in the lab, apparently, to get a fingerprint. Arg. No, that's not what I intended.
Not a good time.
The elevator nearly killed me.
Sounds bad. then maybe you should stop wandering around.
Hey.
I better get going.
Yeah.
Now, that's quite sympathetic, dude. Quite sympathetic. Throw the plant out of its pot. The plant. Is there a plant somewhere? Not here. It's a fireproof container. Oh. Can I... I'd like to... No. Grab the plant. Grab a plant. Here's a plant. There's a plant. Everywhere a plant. Apparently I don't need to do that just yet, or the game's just not letting me do it at the moment. But that's okay. It's a hallway or lobby. Let's get some hints, because, I mean, we get the basic idea. As described in the biometrics book. Yeah, I don't know. Where's the biometrics book even at? Is that in the lab? Got a beaker. Oh, hey, look, we got a beaker. That was easy. All right. Hang on, turn this off. Place the beaker there.
I need to make a fingerprint mold first.
Okay, fine. So the beaker stays there. I still need to make a fingerprint mold. But that's why you're saying look for a coffee mug, because that could contain the bears. The beaker is even better. But I need a fingerprint mold first. Now, surely that was Nico's lab down there, so I need to get a fingerprint of Nico. Apparently I cannot do so on the scanner itself, which is surprising. You would think that, of anything, the scanner would have the clearest fingerprint, but I need to lift a print some other way. And the only other prints could be found in Nico's office. So... So, back into Nico's office we go. And hopefully this time we can manage to get a fingerprint. Well, that didn't work. That didn't work. That also didn't work. Let's get a clue. A place they weren't able to access, which would be this drawer.
Thank you.
I mean, for sure, police weren't able to access this, but there's no reason Nico's fingerprints would be found anywhere around there. The only other place would be in the lab proper, right? That'd be the only place I could find a fingerprint that they couldn't access. This could all be accessed, the proper access codes and stuff. Yeah, I have no idea where to find a fingerprint. I mean, it's got to be in the lab, but... Hey, look, we got another wafer, guys.
Is there anyone there?
Nope. This is disturbing. I'm gonna need far clearer directions. Alright, we need another hint, guys. The locked model display case in Nico's office hasn't been opened recently. Let's get a move on. Crap.
What's that?
That was close. That was really freaking close. Okay. So, what did we find? I grabbed a thing, I didn't even have a chance to look at what it was. I thought I grabbed it. I apparently failed to grab it. My bad. Well, hopefully that doesn't break the game.
I need to make a fingerprint mold first.
Alright, fine. Fine. Hopefully I did not break the game. Ryan's gonna hate me because I'm gonna ask her again to let me back into that office so I can look at the thing that got dropped. Ryan is definitely gonna hate me, but what can you do? What do you have to say, Ryan?
Can you distract Victor for me again?
Okay.
Got it. Cool. Hopefully Ryan's soul is not crushed too much by the end of all of this. S- So I applied this here, got the fingerprint thing, and something fell out of the cabinet. And then I did a sequence break by failing to look at the thing, or only taking the most cursory inspection of it, before heading out of the room in a huge rush. It's possible I blew it. I might have broken the game. Because anybody in their right mind would not do what I did, except in that one very particular... Oh, here it is. Okay. I'm not going to lounge about there if I don't have to. If I can examine said evidence... Okay. Attention, technology of tomorrow today, license and sale. All parties are pleased that the patents are in order and in process. Our legal team asked me to convey again the importance of publishing a verified proof of concept as soon as possible. We've run the numbers, and even the most modest profit valuation puts this project firmly in the unpurchasable category. I mean that we don't have the money to pay you what it's worth because no one has that much money. The process for wires transfer of energy would be literally invaluable. What we can do is help you license the technologies involved. When you're ready, we want to have that conversation. You'll see a cut of every kilowatt hour on the planet once we've done our part. I need to address a rather distressing matter. There have been whispers that your team is considering going into the res commune route with this approach, releasing it freely into the public domain. Please, for love of all things investable, tell me it isn't so. While we approve your worthy impulse, we cringe at the thought of this wasted opportunity. If philanthropy is your aim, remember that you can always donate some of your vast earnings to charity, but only if you make those earnings to begin with. Finally, this is something I not stress enough, while the entire process is priceless, the individual elements are not. Any portion of Nico's work could fetch millions on the speculative market. Until the deal is finalized, I can't help but see us in a somewhat vulnerable position. Time is of the essence. Okay. So it's attention to this lab from someone called Crawford Rumney. Alright. So we'll go bug Ryan. Sorry about all that, Ryan.
Goodbye.
Later.
Make a fake fingerprint.
Haven't done that. Can't check that off yet.
All right. So, we've got a piece of tape. We got some weirdo device here. Yeah. Oh, hey, look. Got a message. The eagle has left the nest. All right. I wonder how Ryan's mood is doing.
What's up?
I'd better get going.
Bye.
Okay. Make a fake fingerprint. Help me out. You need a mold and a gelatinous substance. Yep.
Yes?
I'd better get going.
Later.
It's the biometrics book. I mean, I saw the biometrics book in the lab. Still, what could be used as a mold?
Hey.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Okay. Yeah, maybe that's just a vacuum over there. Or maybe it's something from one of my earlier sessions, like a card reader or something. In any event, it's not helping me in terms of producing a mold. All right. so security agent is out, as is expected, because they work the night shift. So where's this biometrics book? Is there anything that could serve as a mold? Like, this is manufacturing design and how you prototype things. How do you do photolithography etching, which we covered last session. You're pretty thorough about the... Oh! I am remembering something I saw forever ago. You'd think I would remember some of these things a little bit more easily. Does the wafer not fit in the beaker or something? Can I not apply these things to each other somehow? No, I cannot.
I need to find something to melt these in. I need to make a fingerprint mold first.
Okay, a fingerprint mold. I'm going to ask for another hint. To a blank wafer. Oh, using the etcher. Okay. Yeah. Don't forget to use the correct etching solution. So again, we've got a silicon wafer. That makes sense. That's how we replicate the fingerprint. Oops. So yeah, let's go over to this etcher. Now I have to prepare a solution, which prepare out here. All right, the silicon solution requires hydrofluoric acid, nitric acid, and water in a 3:1:4 ratio. So there's our 4 water. We need 3 hydrofluoric acid. And 1 nitric acid. Okay, there we go. We've got our etching solution. And then we can go over here, pour in the formula, put our design in, apply the wafer, and then hit the go button, and give that some time. Alright, so now we're in the clear. We've got to wait another day or so. So we shall wait. Right, yeah, I've got the gummy bears ready to melt. I just needed to create the mold first. So, even though I partially remembered the solution, there was an important step of that I forgot, which was how to make the mold. I have seen a playthrough of this many, many, many months ago, and certainly I don't remember it all. So hopefully the wafer is not destroyed and I prepared the solution properly. Yeah, we got our fingerprint. Nice. I'll step out of here. and see if we can make a mold out of this. Now we have a fingerprint.
Did that. Have it done that.
Well, it's formality at this point. But yeah, we've made a fake fingerprint. That should get us past the biometric scanner. Nice. Okay. Success! The last tests show that wireless transmission streamed up by Tesla is possible. Tonight's tests will confirm it. What today exists in the mind alone, may tomorrow will be shared with the world. 13119754. I do not care for business. The whole endeavor of turning a profit on the work of others is distasteful. This must be Tesla. I don't know. I find more value in the art of creation. Not that he yet created anything. I wonder if it ever stood closely that. What's the point of this writing? Just last week, a young engineering student gave me a letter asking if I was bitter about losing so much residual compensation for my work. It's particularly disappointing leaving him, disappointing learning this from a young scientific mind. He did not ask about the recently made public breakthrough about the transverse waves. He had no curiosity nagging at him about the transmission of thin quest force. Or this great force. He cared about money and little else. Solid proof he'll do well in the present field of scientific research. Okay, there's a lot to this journal. We'll get back to it. Can I not take this? I cannot. All right, fine. New mind must be freed. Must remain. Okay, new maid here must be fired. This roof must remain a haven, and the seed and crumbs for the pigeons must not be disturbed. I have spoken to her and have met resistance. I must find someone who will handle this for me and soon. The radio waves continue to behave in odd, surprising ways. Clicks always together in a sequence continue to be achieved in the lab. I've isolated any local and atmospheric disturbances from these events. Radio wave communication will not be limited to use on the planet. There's potential for other signals from other civilizations to be found. This is an uncertainty, but a perplexing uncertainty. I'll continue to observe. Edison has asked after me, or so I've been told. I find it hard to believe. And moreover, I don't care. If he's interested in meeting, it'll be only because the world has become wise to his strategies. His career contributing proof that of given the choice, the world much prefers a showman to a researcher. He is no doubt determined to prove that direct current has its merits, which it does, is the unique quality of lining Edison's pockets in a way alternating current never could. Colorado will not be forgotten. What I have proven here will lay the foundation for a new way of the world. Edison, Morgan, the others have looked into a way of thinking that will lead to segmentation and strangulation of resources. My work here, improving, has proven the Earth in itself a conductive body. My work here is proving, has proven, the Earth itself is a conductive body. Earth itself is charged, pulsing with electricity that we must simply urge toward our needs. The world is urging me to walk, but I must run. I have proven the need for a new facility on the eastern coast. With what I've established here, it is time to apply this on a larger scale. Radio waves will cross the Atlantic and return. The energy of the Earth itself will follow on command, ceaselessly and without Edison's heavy hand, flow on command, ceaselessly and without, I assume he means fail, without Edison's heavy hand. Man from the military has written again. He is most keenly interested in a sealed prototype of an energy ray. The prospect is interesting and entirely formable, but as it stands, I am too locked up in the questions of resonance. I am close to a result and sure of my work, yet not entirely sure of the next step of application. It will no doubt factor into my work at the Eastern Lab. Still, my idea is somewhat interesting. Another scramble for funding has become the focus of my time. A week of work has been lost, and surely more will follow suit. I must get someone to manage these affairs. Men in suits, they're saying into my work. Perhaps I could engineer a ray of some sort to deter them, but to clear them from my surroundings. Men in suits hoisting contracts. I don't know. Oh, he wants a sealed prototype. Often see the right. Yeah. Well, so those are some of the thoughts of Tesla. I'm not perfectly reading that, but you get the general gist of what that is. He does enjoy his research and believes he can make the world a better place. Is there anything else? 13119754. I guess I'll take a photo. Memory full. Don't need the fingerprint of the thing. Don't need this picture of the flawed thing. Let's go back to the menu. Take the camera. Take the photo. Sure. Nice.
Still have to do that.
What's there left to explore of Nico's study?
Looks like it's powered off.
Oh.
I can't do that yet.
Okay. Journal, early fall. More tape. This is a nice little haven here.
yet.
Okay. Can I apply this somewhere? Listen to the audio diaries from Nico's study. So to do that, I have to get access to Victor's... I'm sorry, to Nico's office that Victor is occupying. But before I do that, I want to make sure I've collected as much as possible here. I get the sense that since I've not been evicted from this room, I'm actually kind of safe here. And so I needn't be in so much of a hurry to read Tesla's diary. Although, yeah, I mean, the general context of the message is the same. Is there anything else here? That seems to be it.
Still have to do that.
Oh, the danger? I don't know. There's just all kinds of factors. Like, I should not be snooping around nearly to the extent that I am. There's like a million reasons I shouldn't be this deep into the lab. So I gotta go bug Ryan again in order to be able to listen to the audio diaries from Nico's study. We need to get back to Nico's office, to the audio player. So hopefully Ryan's not going to hate us too much.
Can you distract Victor for me again?
Sure.
All right, thank you. I don't know how Victor puts up with her. It's pretty funny. Right. All right. Nico Diary 3.
It's Tuesday. 26 hours of work this week. Off to a running start. Ryan's getting more aggressive with her demands. I'm reluctant to send her packing, but I will if I must. My safety is my primary concern. Which reminds me, the parts arrived today for the pigeon. 13.
Thirteen, six, five. That's funny. Okay. So Figure out the importance of frequency 37.
Did that. Haven't done that.
Got... Oh, 6 of 7 magnets. I wonder if Ryan's got a magnet.
Hi.
I'd better get going.
Bye.
Man, we've got so much evidence. Figure out the importance of frequency 37, eh? Well, we still don't have the message from Ryan saying... Oh, we do? Yeah, apparently we do have the message saying that Victor's coming back. Okay, so what else is there? The importance of frequency 37. I guess back to the lab we go, because we've explored everything else pretty thoroughly. Yeah, now there's the alert that the eagle has left the nest. Saying that I should not be in Nico's office because Victor's coming back to Nico's office. We've thoroughly used this room. I have no need of another wafer. I could always take one, but...
I don't need another board right now.
Okay. Is there anything we've missed in the lab? Oops, that's not where I want to go. It says I have 6 of 7 magnets, but I've looked all around this. Oh, missing the one in plain sight. Now I've got 7 of 7 magnets.
Can't check that off yet.
Still have not explored Nico's study, but we have all his magnets.
I can't do that yet.
Okay. Is there anything in this study that I have not clicked on? Anything at all? Apparently not.
This must be the building Nico mentioned.
Huh. We'll take that. Okay. Is this something I can't... Oh. I've already been in the cabinet. I'm still curious what that port on the ground is for, but... Alright. Is there anything in here?
I need to find the correct frequency.
Yeah, you do. Lucky for us, I think this is the correct frequency. 13, 11, 9, 7, 5, 4. Oh, 37. 37 would be... how do you add this up? 24... 33... So, the first three and the last one. Nice. I admit I've seen the part of this game before, so I do recall some of the solutions. So that's
I can't do that yet. That's
how I managed to blaze through that so quickly. You'll have to forgive me. Okay. Oh, it's Dr. Gray's, or the, yeah, it's Gray's game. Oh, that's no good. This might not work. All right, let's try again. That didn't work at all. So I want to hit as many yellow dots on an iteration as I can. That also failed really badly. Two charges remain. This will send a oh. I thought that would send it both ways, but no. This fails. There's no solution at this point. That's also not so great. How do I hit as many yellow targets as possible at once? Okay. That was largely wasted. This is no good. It's very close, but no good.
That's done.
Okay. I'm not sure I want to do that first. Not exactly what I was looking for, but it's not terrible. How do I get something to shoot the one in the corner? I think at that point I'm already lost anyway. Let's try the ones on the edges first. I wonder, is there exactly one solution? There might be exactly one. In which case, that's going to make this really difficult to discover. Alright, so how do I beat this game? Do I hit the ones in the middle first? Okay, we got two charges remaining. That go with the middle strategy first seems to be more effective. Nice.
Have it done that.
Oh, now we got a password. There's no way this is the password. Where could I expect to find the password for Nico's video system?
Check.
It's not in Tesla's journal, because there's no way Tesla could possibly know Nico's password. Unless there's a clue on the whiteboard or somewhere. I mean, maybe Gray would have had some idea. Well, so... here's, like, password to one of Gray's lockers. This is not Nico's. Okay, Nico. Certainly believe I can do what I say. You'd better as well. Faraday cage is starting to fail. Sent a materials request to Victor. May need to refabricate the cage before winter. Ellie should be made aware of the issue, of course. As long as it's only two of us using the coil, it should hold for a little while longer. Call Victor to have him expedite the materials before something disastrous happens. Need a photosensitive paint Well, that's interesting. Photosensitive paint could be used for that light under the glow stuff. Faraday materials. Magnets, USB drives. Science Desk Tribune, fabricating stories, and Dominion Blacklist. More research materials are missing today. Keep closer watch on Ellie. Every fifth letter above play on the coil. So it's all up to you guys. Figure out how to get me a password, or I'll have to use a hint, or I'll have to wander. There's no way. Well, we have an audience. What would you prefer? Would you want me to use a hint? Should I go looking about, trying to find the password? Should I just keep clicking on everything and maybe I'll actually find it? So, our remaining tasks say, discover the pigeon's secret, turn on Nico's video system and see what's on it, find the password for Nico's video system. We do have a number of magnets, which were one of the things that Nico identified. In fact, we've got 7 of 7 magnets. Maybe it's time to discover the pigeon's secret. Oops, not there. Other door. I always get the two of those doors confused. Alright. I'm just gonna randomly guess, like, this being the last item we got. It's a metallic pigeon. Maybe the magnets somehow help us with the pigeon.
Hi! Can you distract Victor for me again? Sure.
Okay. I don't know how Victor doesn't catch on to any of this.
What was Nico up to with a pigeon?
I don't know, but we got some.
This must be what Nico was talking about in his diary.
Oh, crap. Nico's diary. That was Tesla's diary downstairs. That's no good. That's not a diary. Nico's diary. I don't have a diary by Nico. Oh, hang on. Never mind, I've got audio diaries.
It's Tuesday. 26 hours of work this week. Off to a running start. Ryan's getting more aggressive with her demands. I'm reluctant to send her packing, but I will if I must. My safety is my primary concern. Which reminds me, the parts arrived today for the pigeon. 13.
Right. 13, 6, 5. 8, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 1. Oh. 1902 patent. Okay, noted.
This must be the key to one of Nico's.
Okay, cool. Can I pick up the magnets now? No. Of course I can't. Well, okay, I'm just going to leave the magnets there. 1902 patent. Well, there is that book in the guest room. 1902 patent would be the apparatus for transmitting electrical energy. Camera. No. Oh, we're not full in terms of just camera memory. So, sure. 1139732. Okay, we'll hit the button. It's around here somewhere. Just hopefully that keeps people out of the lab, but I have no idea. It probably actually has no effect. Okay. Password. Password, password, password. Electronics. Nope, that's not my phone. There's my phone. Let's take a look at my photos. 1119732. What's going on here? Well, damn. That's not good. That's even worse.
Victor! He must have killed Nico.
Well, shit.
Evidence out.
Yeah. Okay. Shit. Wait, why do I have to get the evidence out? Why can't I just... Well, isn't that colorful?
Did that. Check. Did that.
Get the USB with the video out of the lab.
No. Nico security. Of course. I bet all of my electronics just got fried.
Damn. Now, can't I just summon the police? Tell them what I found, and just, I mean, I've done my work as a private investigator and I'm done. Would that not be suitable for this? Okay. At least we got some clarity as to what's going on.
I'll explain later. I just need a way to get the video out without getting it ruined.
You need to find a way to make a Faraday cage. That should get the drive out without wiping it. get the drive out. I'll work on what to do next. Take this. It'll help.
Okay. Sure, why not?
This box might be just what I need to build a Faraday container. This might work.
Nice.
Or maybe it'll backfire and electrocute you.
Sweet.
What? Sorry. I'm just so happy we're gonna bust him. I'm also really scared he'll catch us and kill us all. I'm on a roller coaster right now. Ellie and I will gas up the snowmobiles and split up to double our chances of reaching help. Do not let him catch on. If he knows you're about to get the video out, he will kill you. Play it cool, Nancy.
Goodbye.
Later.
Save game. Doom. Yeah. That pretty much speaks about my optimism of getting out of here alive. Really not optimistic. Okay, I can't use this workbench, apparently. Here, do you want some components? Are you hungry? Too bad. No, but seriously, why do I not just report this to the police? I mean, if everybody safely escaped the lab and Victor hasn't figured out what's going on, it's not like Victor can... whatever. I wish we could trust Gray. He would be, like, I don't know. He could really help us out big time. Instead, we confide all our trust in Ryan. I just help but feel we could have made better choices. So, what do I do with the box if I don't have a place to... I have a tabletop here. Oh, we've got space here as well.
I need to find some foil first. I must have seen some earlier.
Foil. Oh, the photolithography lab. It's not that I need a wafer, I need the foil that covers the wafers. Okay. And now we've got the box, we got the foil. Let's go back over here.
Time to make a portable Faraday cage. Hope this works.
Nice.
Have it done that.
Portable Faraday cage, eh?
I can't do that yet.
Fine.
I don't think it's time for that yet.
Oh, I have to seal this together or something?
I can't do that yet. This box should keep the drive safe.
Nice.
Check that off yet.
Okay. Yeah. Let's go back to the lab. Go get this video. What could possibly go wrong?
Nothing. The electromagnetic pulse from the door must have destroyed the USB drive.
Oh, come on!
I need to transfer the evidence to a drive before Victor can destroy it. Must have gotten zapped by Nico's security system. I need to transfer the evidence to a drive before Victor can destroy it.
Victor doesn't even know about this place.
I need to transfer the evidence to a drive before Victor can destroy it.
I mean, we're the only ones who have access to this.
I need to transfer the evidence to a drive before Victor can destroy it.
Okay. How can I get another USB stick? Where is my... I thought I could reuse the USB stick. All my work fails due to lack of a USB stick. Well, that seems like the sort of thing we should bother Ryan about. Oh, Ryan's not here. Not only that, but all the gummy bears are taken because I took them earlier. And Ryan has not managed to procure more gummy bears. Seriously, is it that hard to find a USB stick somewhere? Or to unfry the one that I have? Maybe I should just go bother Victor again. I mean, what's the worst that could happen? Yeah, I've read this before. I mean, the only other person I can still bother is Gray. But no. Victor might have a USB stick. Hey, Victor, do you mind if I borrow? he's not here. Candy's gone. Okay. Is there any way to unfry? I don't think so. Well, that's unfortunate. I mean, of all the ways to lose this game, lacking a USB stick is probably the most impressive. Nothing in there. I mean, I could play the memory game, but what's the point? It could be fun if I wanted more candy. So, yeah, let's just sleep in the guest room. Just be all nonchalant about the fact that we're just kind of helplessly sitting here. It's just incredible. Like, seriously. My kingdom for a USB stick. Let's ask Gray how things are going. Oops, he's over here.
Yeah, what?
I think Victor killed Nico.
You have proof?
Yes, but it got zapped coming out of Nico's lab.
Find a way to get it and keep it safe. I'll take care of Victor. Be fast.
What's the real story between you and Nico?
Huh.
I was the smart one between the two of us. He was just a scrawny kid with bad acne and a lisp who begged me to help him figure out his constants.
Weird.
We took off together, but the higher we rose in our studies, he got stronger. He wasn't a scrawny kid anymore. And me, I woke up one day and the floor wasn't there.
Wow.
He said I was a burnout. It was worse than that. But you wouldn't understand.
Try me.
The way we think about everything is completely wrong. Even time is an illusion. It's nothing. It doesn't exist.
I'm sure it does.
You think it does, but it doesn't. We aren't even here.
Whatever, man.
A holographic projection of a fixed point of high density information located far off in what we think of as deep space.
That's just your opinion.
That headspace, I got caught there. I couldn't function. From that day, Nico had my back. When things got dangerous for him, I tried to watch his. Couldn't in the end.
Well, damn.
Now, can you tell me what you were hiding earlier? Were you destroying something?
Knowledge this world can't have.
Is that up to you to decide?
Yes. Science isn't moral or amoral. It just is. To get to where he needed to go, Nico discovered some things that are very dangerous.
Like,
well, that's an AlphaGo t-shirt.
Discoveries with potential military application.
Or DeepMind.
He couldn't censor himself, but he didn't want to be another Nobel or Oppenheimer.
Huh.
He made me promise if anything ever happened to him, I'd destroy everything that people would abuse.
He trusted you to know the difference?
And only me. If I don't finish here, Nico's work might end up doing a lot more harm than good.
Wow.
If it's so important, what would have happened if you had both died?
There was a contingency we considered, and thankfully did not have to enact.
That's fortunate.
I better get going.
Bye.
Wow.
Again? What?
I'll let you go.
Yeah, yeah.
So, I still need a USB stick. My kingdom for a USB stick. Seriously. Well, looks like I'm gonna ask for a hint. Uh-huh. Oh, jeez. Really?
Did that.
Oh, okay. I did get the USB stick out of the lab, but it got fried in the process. Get some help. Thank you, game. Thank you for not helping. Or at least not directly. Oh, hang on. No, my phone still doesn't work. It's still fried. Everything's still dark and dreary. And I don't have a way to get the video out. So, yeah. Looks like this is it for Nancy Drew, guys. Let's save the game. Stalemate. In the sense that, you know, done everything I can, but without a USB stick, I can't save the day. I can turn this knob off and on and off. Maybe if I do that enough, signals will go out to the power company and tell them that we need help. That seems to be my best plan at the moment. Short of just getting the heck out of here.
Time to solve the case of the missing toilet paper.
Yeah, it's an important case. That's a book. That's not a USB stick. Bang head here. Repeat as necessary. But seriously, why do I need to get the evidence out of Nico's study? Can't I just tell the police that there's evidence there? Appear to be stuck in the worst possible way. The book about the Tesla coil, it's a thing about Faraday cages, use the box of Orion as the base. Yeah. Now, I've built the damn cage game. The game won't let me put the video onto the dead USB. I need to undeadify the USB. In the lounge, head there and piece together your Faraday cage. I have very much done this.
Still have to do that.
No. I have done this all. But... yeah. I am just running low on ideas at the moment. Right. Now, where could I possibly find that? Do I have to take apart the audio player? I don't know. Do I go into the lab somewhere? There's a USB stick somehow. Do I create a USB stick out of the components? This really shouldn't be part of the... Look in the tech workshop. Okay. Thanks for nothing. What a fantastic game. Overall, it's pretty good. I just have to give it some crap once in a while. Oh my goodness. Okay. Well, is that so hard? We're gonna save the game as stalemate number 2. Right, and then... approach this all at night while Gray is here. Just in case that matters. I'm not sure that it does, but that could be important since apparently everybody else has left. I'm the only person who lacks the sensibility to leave, instead believing somehow that it is noble to do what I'm doing. Oops, let's push the big red button, as we usually do. Thanks. Yeah, I've got the rocket ship USB. Just put the Just push the button for good luck, you know. So yeah, now I'm exploring this at night, just for to increase the dramatic tension of it all.
Okay, it's transferred. All right, I just might be able to get this through the door safely.
All right. You know, if I have... Okay. For the common sense to do that. And I do. Oh, thanks for Googling that. Alright, you ready? Here we go. Let's get on out of here.
Hello, Nancy.
Sup? How's it going? Oh, crap.
You're awake. Well, that's unfortunate for you.
Victor, why are you doing this?
Stay out of the lab. That was the one thing I asked you to do, and you couldn't. You see, Nancy, I knew Nico had something hidden in him. I just couldn't find it, which is why I asked you to stay out.
You got away with murder. Why not make a break for it? Why the elaborate plan?
Murder investigations don't just go away. Someone had to take the fall, Nancy. You were supposed to give someone a push. That friend of yours sold you short. That's why you're here. You were supposed to drum up enough evidence to get Ryan put away. But no, you had to screw that up. Then I handed you Ellie and Mason. Handed them to you on a big silver platter and said, look how guilty these two are.
You knocked me out, and then planted the key card.
That should have sealed the deal, but you couldn't leave it alone. I guess I should be congratulating you for being so sharp. It really is a shame I'd have to kill you instead. Goodbye, Nancy Drew!
The pit won't last long against the spoilers. We'll need to find a way to get out without getting electrocuted. I bet Ryan's electrical components will help here.
Nice.
This must be the schematic for the circuit.
Okay. So... Oops. Alright. We've got a transistor down there. Oh crap, so many parts. Alright. So we got some integrated circuits at several points in this circuit.
Like, we need to get this working before it's too late.
Yep. Crap. Which one's this integrated circuit? I can't tell. I'm gonna die here, guys. So it's been nice knowing you. Crap. Where's... Okay, this goes over here. Then we have a resistor here. No, a resistor. Or a diode or something. There's a transistor down there. Oh my goodness. This is not good, guys. Okay, three resistors. We can add those. One here. One here. One here, I suppose. Capacitor fits here. Resistor fits here. Diode fits there, something. Capacitor. Capacitor fits this gap. Oh, shoot, no. This is not a capacitor. This is transistor. I'm just kind of guessing at this point, unfortunately. It's just not going to go well. All right, so that's not the correct schematic. I'm not seeing where the integrated circuit goes in all of this. Or the inductor, Inductor's the squiggly thing. Where's the inductor go? Oh, it's on the left. Okay. Diode. So one diode in each of these sections. Let's put a diode there, resistor here. That's not correct. Yeah, we're gonna die. That's too bad. Diode, resistor. Resistor, capacitor, diode. This is really tricky. Resistor and a diode. This shouldn't matter.
Got it. This should give me a chance to escape.
What are you doing?
Nice!
Dear Hannah,
whew.
Victor was rushed to the hospital and then to a courthouse where he was charged with the murder of Niko Jovic. Due to his attempts to subvert justice, he's been denied bail until his trial. Word is he's willing to strike a plea deal for leniency. But I doubt there will be much to be found. The potential buyers Victor had been courting came forward immediately.
Wow.
It was quickly proven they had no idea about Victor's involvement in Nico's death. Regardless, they decided to cut funding for the lab immediately.
Damn.
You can hardly blame them. Mason snuck back into the lab the night after Victor's arrest and made off with a drive containing years of his and Nico's research. Gray spent weeks chasing him down until he finally caught him trying to make a sale at the Technology of Tomorrow conference. After a heated public argument that sent the Technology of Tomorrow bloggers into a frenzy, the two reached an agreement. Gray promised all due credit would remain with Mason and Ellie, provided they assist him in finishing Nico's work. A video of the argument titled Epic Dork Fight was posted online and went viral almost immediately.
Damn.
Within 2 hours, Gray was fielding calls from philanthropic backers wishing to fund their new endeavor. Mason, on the other hand, was fielding date requests from viewers who clearly have a profound affinity for the lost art of arguing.
Oh, yeah.
Ellie was surprised at first to hear that Mason wanted her to assist with finishing up Nico's work.
What?
She agreed to stay on until the first publication is completed. After that, she plans on doing whatever it takes to get back home.
Of course.
She's not sure what her next endeavor will be, but she's excited to make that decision alongside her family. Finding out what had happened to his best friend changed Gray almost immediately. For the first time since his breakdown, he decided to fully re-enter the world of science.
Nice.
He took the lead on finishing Nico's work and opening the majority of the research up to the public. Some of the work he plans to destroy, as he promised. Although she had been exonerated, it wasn't until Ryan knew exactly what happened to Nico that she could begin to move on from what happened that night. She decided to stay with the team during the next research phase on the condition that she can personally address all safety issues before each experiment.
Cool.
More than anything, Nico wanted his work to make the world a better place. I'd like to think he'd be very proud to see the team working hard to prepare his work for public release. The fact that Niko Jovic's name will be known the world over, while Victor's won't, again proves what I always believed. The world fondly remembers those who always give, and soon forgets those who only take. Can't wait to see you. Love, Nancy.
Very cool. Also, yes, death by Tesla coil is definitely a pretty epic way to go. Who was Nikola Tesla's partner during the War of the Currents? It was Charles Batchelor, right? Yeah. Alright. So, we got the Alarmist Award for consistently raising the alert. Pretty Kitty Award for assembling the cat. The Easter Egg Award for finding the Easter Egg, literally. Oh, I did not ace the final test. That's too bad. Playing the boards. sampling all of Nico's candy. Creating many formulas. Oh, interesting. Wait. How come I don't get an award for leaving Mason's desk the way it was? I did never, ever disturb Mason's desk. Alright. For running wireless energy tests. Really? You can... Oh. I mean, that really aggravates Victor and... not just Victor, but Gray. But apparently you can do that. Creating shockingly beautiful music. Acing the final test is something I blew it. But I thought his partner was... anyway. Yeah, what a fantastic game. Really... Overall, the story, the music, the artwork, the development... Like, I guess the development is part of the story, but... even the puzzles themselves were all quite good. Yes, this was a point-and-click adventure game, and at times got very aggravating because the point-and-click nature of that just doesn't suit games in general. But, yeah, it's overall, this is quite excellent. Thornton.
Around here, they say. Wicked place. Abandoned years ago by a family who could no longer take the endless nights when the restless spirits of the past haunted the grounds of Thornton Hall. Jessalyn Thornton dared return only to vanish without a trace. It's up to me to save her from the ghost of Thornton Hall.
Dun dun dun. Don't want that to happen. Yeah, there are some people who would take endless amusement out of messing with Mason's desk, and the thought of it amuses me, but also the thought of just annoying Mason bothers me. Like, I understand if that's his way of coping with the world, okay, people can teach him a lesson or two, but that doesn't mean people should go out of their way to be mean to him. Yeah, just in time. Welcome. You just missed everything. So, yeah. So here's the actress for Ryan Kilpatrick. It's Catherine Grant Suddy. Nico's Josh, and Deidre Shannon's Megan Halverson. I'm sure these credits are available online as well. It's amazing how many people work together to make this game not only possible, but a reality. It's quite fantastic. And that said, I waited forever on Steam to get this. It's not... It's difficult to find on sale for the prices that most people are willing to pay for it. And I just happened to get exceptionally lucky finding it on sale one time. Ellie York, Gray Courtright. Again, that's the DeepMind t-shirt, if I remember right. Mason Quinto. Ryan Kilpatrick. That's a nice outfit. It's really colorful. Victor Lazet. Very trendy. Although he doesn't look pretty happy. Niko Jovic. Looks... I don't know. Science team, assemble!
Gubby.
You know that's a tragedy, right?
But soft, what light through yonder window breaks, it is the east, and Juliet is a gummy bear.
Okay, I don't think the tragedy aspect of you is bothering you. Alright. Technology of today, tomorrow, today, something. He's going to sit around like a normal person, but he just glared. She got the two of them. Oh. Okay.
Gummy Bear Theater presents The Deadly Device. How does Ryan know the title of the game?
It's too meta. I'm just a gummy bear. I have enough trouble with simple concepts. I'm blue!
Well, that's original. I really like that scene. No! No! That's terrible. Wow. Okay, so, yeah, no, I really like that one scene of Shannon and Victor. It's just brings closure to the whole game, really. Well, that and the epilogue preceding it. But yeah, this whole game was very professionally produced, designed, animated, scored, and even tested. I'm sure really thorough testing went into this game. One thing that did agitate me through this, I mean, the music is supposed to be tense. I do struggle with that kind of tension in a game. I prefer not for my games to be this tense. But it suits the game. It works really well. But, man, I would have preferred something a little bit less intense. Just in terms of knowing when characters are going to pop up and greet you. Just something a little less extreme in that regard, and something requiring more, I don't know. I just don't like the sense of working under the sort of pressure that the game puts on you. I prefer a greater skill, and less of a, less of a narrative experience. I prefer for more of a puzzle-based game. But that's just my personal preference, and I think that the soundtrack and the programming and the timing of the puzzles and the other characters popping up and finding you in the video scenes, it's all intended to trigger you a little bit. It's really professionally well done. I think at some future time I will want to replay this and put the game into expert or sleuth mode. Just to really have challenging puzzles. I didn't do that this first time around, at least not consciously so. Perhaps I did at the beginning and I just don't recall. But I think there are ways to make the game super challenging puzzle-wise. And I do want to try that. I'll have to go back and look at my first step of my first part of the playthrough and see what difficulty I picked. Because I do really enjoy a good academic challenge. In particular, one that would put some of my study at college to good use would be most appreciated. Although 99% of gamers would probably find that way over their heads, like in terms of redux reactions and circuit board printing and testing and designing your own circuits and calculating a voltage drop and applying calculus and multi-variable calculus and differential equations. and quantum physics and all that. I would appreciate more in that venue. But that's my own cup of tea, so I needn't impose that on the more casual gamer. The person who plays a game because they enjoy the narrative and enjoy the game, and don't need the puzzles to be, like, stupidly complicated in terms of an academic curve, as opposed to being complicated because you have to figure out what to click and where to click it. Some of the puzzles were pretty confusing in terms of looking at, like, how to apply the binary numbers. You'd think I'd eventually get the hang of that. I think I did, with the pigeon at the end. But, yeah, some of the recurring puzzle aspects of it, where there's a cipher, is challenging. I don't know, I think this game was really well done. It's quite fun. There are extras here. It could take a minute to check these out. Credits, outtakes, teaser. Let's take a look at outtakes. Again, I say that that's the DeepMind t-shirt, but yeah. Oh no, I think we've been through everything then. So that's been fun. Honestly, I've not tried Quantum Chess. I've taken a look at it. It's not chess-like. It's its own animal. And there's various criticisms I have of it. I mean, it's one thing that it's got the quantum entanglement and randomness to it, but the part I dislike is the whole double moving aspect, which just completely breaks the rules of chess. Like, I like the quantum entanglement that makes it way more complicated, but I don't like the fact that it changes how the pieces move, which is just completely ridiculous. But to each their own. So yeah, hope you've enjoyed. For those who stuck with me from the beginning, kudos. Yeah, we started this back in Halloween. It only took us 2.5 months to complete the game, so hopefully if I do play another round of this sometime, next round will be much swifter. There have been multiple producers of the Nancy Drew series. I do really like this team who produced this game. There have been a lower budget team that made a lower budget game, which was, those games are okay, but this game was just excellent throughout. And, the only criticism I have is that it's a point and click game and that you have to go finding things and pointing and clicking until you find the right thing. Other than that, everything about this was just perfect. So yeah, very nice, very well done. So yeah, thanks for joining me. Hope you enjoyed it. Take care, and I'll see you around.